Hello, my dear geographers. I hope everyone is keeping well. So once again, welcome back to our geography class. Today in this class, I am going to start with a new topic of class 11 ISC, that is marine processes and associated landforms. So basically, marine processes are that process which is highly associated with sea and the oceans, right? So there are different types of terminologies present. We need to learn that one by one. We will see the different terminologies, and without any further delay, let's move on to the topic. So first, as I told you, that marine processes are those which are highly associated with the action of waves. Now, what is this waves? Waves means nothing but the up and down movement of the water in the sea. So here, the lower part of the wave is known as wave trough, whereas the upper part of the wave is known as wave crest. Now, the horizontal distance between two successive crests is known as wavelength, and the vertical distance between the crest and trough is known as wave height. We all know that the running water is highly active in the humid climate, whereas wind is active in desert, and glacier it is active in cold regions. So it's quite obvious that sea waves are basic and chief agent of gradation in the coastal areas. So in fact, the coastal topography is highly influenced by the sea waves. Now the erosion, transportation, as well as the depositional activities are done by the sea waves. So as we all know that the natural moving object has three different stages of its life. Number one, young stage, which is highly associated with erosional activity. After that, mature stage, which is associated with transportational activity, and last one is old stage, which is associated with the depositional activity. So here we are going to learn the different activities and their associated landforms. So first we will discuss about the erosional work of sea waves. So basically, the erosional work of sea depends upon the size as well as the strength of the sea waves. So sea waves operate as an agent of erosion in different ways. What are these waves? Let's look into this. There are four waves. Number one, hydraulic action. After that, abrasion. Then attrition. And last one is solution. So number one, it is hydraulic action. Basically, this action involves the picking up of loose material by waves and the shattering of rocks as the waves crash like giant water hammers against the cliff. Now next is abrasion. Now basically it is the mechanical or the frictional force which is responsible for wearing down the rock material which forms the abrasive mechanism. Third one is attrition. Now the rock fragments or the tools of the waves strike against each other and they are reduced in shape. This action is known as attrition. Last but not the least, it is solution. So basically the solvent or soluble rocks such as limestone, dolomite, chalk are highly dissolved by the solution action of sea waves. So these are the four waves of the erosional activity of sea waves. Now let's look into the different features formed by the erosional work of sea waves. So number one, it is sea cliff. What is that? In this picture, you can easily see that. So basically, a scrap face of the coast facing the sea is known as sea cliff. So in the beginning, the sea waves cut a groove in the rock at the sea level, which is known as notch. Okay? And the notch keeps on widening up with the passage of time, and it thus undermines the overhanging rock until it falls into the sea and forms a cliff. So this is all about the sea cliff. Next, we will discuss about sea caves. So sea waves can erode the soft rocks much faster than the hard rocks. We all know that the soft rocks are highly erodible matter, right? Now at several places, rocks are traversed by joints, faults, or bands of weak rocks. Now sea waves easily erode these weak points, leading to the formation of sea caves. It is necessary that the overhanging rock should be strong enough to stand without much support from the below. Now, next one is marine arc or natural bridges. So, here the sea arc, marine arc or the natural bridge is from when the sea waves working from opposite directions are able to cut through the capes. Next one is stack. When the roof of a marine arc collapses, a portion of the arc keeps standing in the sea like a small pillar. So this is known as stack. So this is the one of the major landform of the erosional work of ocean. Right? Now let's see the depositional activity of sea waves and the associated landforms. Depositional activity means the eroded material by the sea waves will be deposited at a particular place. And after the deposition, several features will be formed. So here the first feature that we are going to discuss, that is sea beach. So we all have heard this word sea beach, a beach which is formed due to the deposition of sand, gravel, pebbles on the shore between the low tide level and the coastline. The beach grows in size when waves are less active, but it may be completely destroyed by strong waves in a storm. After that, here is a bar. So a bar is a sort of embankment of sand and gravel built by the depositional work of the sea waves. Now it normally extends between two adjoining headlands of hard rocks, or it runs roughly parallel to the shoreline. Basically, the bars are formed at parallel of the shoreline. After that, it is lagoon. So lagoon, it is also known as half. So when the bars further extend, the seawater is partially enclosed between the coast and the bar, which is known as lagoon lake. A lagoon generally maintains the connection with the open sea through a narrow gap between the bar and the headlands. So in India, Pulikat lakes, now the Chilka lakes along the east coast, and Vembanad on the Kerala coast are the best examples of lagoons in India. So these all are the depositional features of the sea waves. Now another two important terms are here, that is coastline and shoreline. So what is coastline? Basically a boundary between the coast and the shore is known as coastline. And what is shoreline? Shoreline is nothing but it is the fringe of land at the edge of a large body of water like oceans, water, sea water, etc. So this is all about the marine processes and the associated landforms that is there in your syllabus. I hope this is quite clear to you all. Again, in the next class, we will come up with a new topic. Till then, thank you and take care.